Welcome students to class 6th. Today we will continue with our third chapter from geography, and the name of the chapter is Motions of the Earth. So do you know what is the meaning of motion? Motion means the movement of something, you know. And in this chapter we will be understanding motions of the earth, that means movements of the earth. Look at that picture. The earth is given and two arrows are drawn. One side it is written rotation and on the other it is written revolution. Don't confuse these two words. Both are different. Rotation means earth spins around its own axis. For example, you stand in one place and you rotate, okay? That means you go round and round standing on the same place. That is called rotation. Whereas what is the revolution? Revolution means you are moving around something, like one table is kept and you are moving around it. That is called revolution. Okay students, now let's go through the notes. The earth has two types of motions. What is written? The earth has two types of motions. What are they? Rotation and revolution. I had already explained you what do you mean by rotation and revolution. Let's go through the definition to make it more clear. Rotation. Rotation is the movement of the earth on its own axis. The axis which is made on that axis only. And axis is not made. It is an imaginary line. Okay? Then what is revolution? In revolution, the earth moves around the sun in a fixed path or orbit. Okay? That means orbit is also not made of something. It is an imaginary line. Okay? Then what is the difference? Rotation is the movement of the earth on its own axis. Whereas in revolution, the earth moves around the sun. That means earth is moving around the sun. Okay? Then what is written? The earth receives light from the sun. As the shape of the earth is spherical, we already know the earth is spherical in shape. Only half of it gets light from the sun at a time. The other half remains dark. In this way, day and night are caused. So what is written? How day and night are caused? How they are caused? That earth is spherical in shape. That means when the sun reflects light on our earth, then only half space is get light. But half space remain in dark. In this way, the place in which there is no light, that is, at that time there is night. And the area on which, on the earth, the area on which the light is reflected, that is daytime. Okay? Now what is the next point written? The earth completes one rotation around its axis in about 24 hours. In one day, how many hours are there? 24 hours. That means earth rotates one rotation in 24 hours. Okay? We can write it in numerical also. That is, one rotation is equals to 24 hours. Okay? Now, look at the picture. Sun, and what is written? Light rays. Okay? Then sun is reflecting its light on earth. See, only half of the earth is getting. See, on this area, it is day. And on the next back side of the earth, it is night. In this area, it is night. And here, day. And this, you know, this, it is called as circle of illumination. What is the circle of illumination? Did you get? This line, this is known as the circle of illumination. Now read this. देयर आर फोर सीजन्स इन अ ईयर. हाउ मेनी सीजन्स आर देयर इन अ ईयर? समर, विंटर, स्प्रिंग एंड ऑटम. ओके, सीजन्स चेंजेस ड्यू टू द चेंज इन द पोजिशन ऑफ द अर्थ अराउंड द सन. वॉट इज, वॉट डू यू मीन बाय दैट? दैट सीजन चेंजेस. वेन सीजन चेंज? वेन द पोजिशन ऑफ द अर्थ चेंजेस अराउंड द सन. ओके, द रेज ऑफ सन फॉल्स डायरेक्टली ऑन द ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर, हैंस दिस एरियाज आर हॉट. वी हैव स्टडीड इन आवर अर्लियर क्लासेस दैट ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर, दिस एरिया इज वेरी हॉट, और वी कैन से टॉरिड जोन, बिकॉज सन फॉल्स डायरेक्टली, सन रेज फॉल्स डायरेक्टली ऑन दैट एरिया. ओके, देन वॉट इज रिटर्न? द एरिया नियर द पोल्स रिसीव लेस हीट एज द रेज ऑफ द सन आर स्लैंटिंग. दैट मीन्स नियर द पोल्स. ओके, नियर द पोल्स, नियर नॉर्थ पोल एंड नियर साउथ पोल, दिस एरियाज आर कॉल्ड फ्रिजिड जोन्स. वाई? बिकॉज दिस, इन दिस एरियाज सन रेज आर नॉट फॉलिंग डायरेक्टली. ओके, दे आर स्लैंटिंग. नाउ लुक एट द डायग्राम. देर आर फोर सीजन्स. वॉट आर दे? समर, विंटर, ऑटम एंड स्प्रिंग. यू कैन सी इन द डायग्राम. लुक हियर. वेट, वॉट इज रिटर्न हेयर? समर इन द नॉर्थन हेमिस्फीयर, विंटर इन द सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर, दैट इज समर सोलिस्टिक. एंड विंटर इन द नॉर्थन हेमिस्फीयर एंड समर इन द सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर, दैट इज विंटर सोलिस्टिक. एंड वेन देयर इज इक्विनॉक्स, देन देयर इज इक्विनॉक्स ऑन 23rd सेप्टेम्बर, दैट इज ऑटम एंड स्प्रिंग. यू कैन सी ऑटम इन सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर एंड, सॉरी, ऑटम इन नॉर्थन हेमिस्फीयर एंड स्प्रिंग इन सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर. ओके, लाइकवाइज यू कैन सी हेयर, इट इज ऑटम इन सदर्न एंड स्प्रिंग इन नॉर्थन हेमिस्फीयर. दिस विल बी मोर क्लियर विद द डेफिनेशंस. In the northern hemisphere, the longest day and the shortest night occur on 21st June. In the southern hemisphere, the shortest day and the longest night occur on this day. This position of Earth is known as the summer solstice. That means in northern hemisphere, when there is the longest day and shortest night, that is on 21st June. This dates you have to remember. And in the northern hemisphere, shortest day and the longest night on that day, means on 21st June. Then this position of the earth is known as summer solstice. Okay? Then what is next written? When there is summer in the northern hemisphere, southern and southern hemisphere enjoys winter season. That means when there is summer in northern hemisphere, then there is winter in southern hemisphere. Okay, and vice versa. That means when in northern hemisphere there is winter, then there will be summer in southern hemisphere. Now read what is written. Don't get confused in definitions of summer solstice and winter solstice. In northern hemisphere, the shortest day and longest night, that is on 22nd December. And in the southern hemisphere, the longest day and the shortest night occur on this day, on the same day. Okay, this position of the earth is known as winter solstice. It is very simple. Read it with holier concentration, then you will get the meaning. On 21st March and September 23rd, the whole earth experiences equal day and equal night. This phenomena is known as equinox. It is also simple. We have already discussed in the picture. This is winter solstice. Okay, when in the northern hemisphere, the winter solstice occur when sun is directly overhead the tropic of Capricorn. Okay, Then what is written? On 23rd September, it is autumn in the northern hemisphere and spring in the southern hemisphere. We have already discussed. On 21st March, it is summer in the northern hemisphere and autumn in the southern hemisphere. Then what is written? Day and nights occur due to rotation, while changes in seasons occur due to revolution. This you can get, write your points in differences between rotation and revolution. Rotation is the movement of earth on its own axis, whereas revolution means rotation around the sun. Then second point we can add, day and night occur due to rotation, and change in season occur due to revolution. Now let us revise it again in some more detail. Okay, rotation is the movement of earth on its own axis. The axis of earth, which is an imaginary line, makes an angle of 66.5 degrees with its orbital plane. The portion facing the sun experiences day, while the other half always from the sun experiences night. The circle that divides the day from night on the globe is called the circle of illumination. We have already discussed. Then what is written? The earth takes about 24 hours to complete one rotation around its axis. It is known as Earth Day. Please note down all the important points. Then coming to revolution. The movement of the earth around the sun in a fixed path or orbit is called revolution. Earth takes 365 days to revolve around the sun, and it takes 24 hours to rotate around its own axis. Every fourth year, February is of 29 days instead of 28 days. Such a year with 366 days is called a leap year. Earth is going around the sun in a elliptical orbit. What is the orbit? You have to remember this name. Season changes due to change in the position of the earth around the sun. This all we have discussed. This is summer solstice. You can draw the diagram in your copy, so that whenever you read the answer, you can get the all your doubts clear. This is the definition of summer solstice. It is the position of the earth when the northern hemisphere has the longest day and shortest night, and it occurs on 21st June. Hemisphere. The days are short and the nights are long. It occurs on 22nd December and it is winter. It is winter solstice. Okay. On 21st March and September 23rd, direct rays of sun fall on the equator and the whole earth experiences equal day and equal night. This is, what do you mean by this? It is equinox. Again, I have written all the points so that you can get revision 3 times. We have discussed all our chapter 3 times in this video. Rotation, revolution, orbital plane, circle of illumination. You can note down these definitions in your copy. Leap year, winter solstice. Summer solstice. Then equinox. Okay students, with this our chapter is completed. We will discuss our exercise in next chapter. You just note down all the important definitions in your copy and draw the diagrams, which will help you for understanding more clearly.